everyone, it's Tony from White Milk Soaps, and today I'm making transparent soap. In here I've got some argan oil. I'm only using argan oil because I've got a lot of that and I haven't got that much castor oil, but you can use any oil you like, really. It just depends on what type of transparency that you would like your soap to turn out with, but it's all about experimenting. You can use any kind of oil you want, really. So in there I've got 130 grams of the argan oil and 38 grams of castor oil. In here I've got 252 grams of the coconut oil and 99 grams of the stearic acid. That's the grainy one there. You can find stearic acid from any soap supplier. In here I've got my lye, 86 grams of lye, and the glycerin and sugar that comes later on in the recipe. But you will need demineralized water for all this. You can get this at the supermarket, like $3 for 2 litres. Don't try and use mineral water or rain water or anything, because your soap will turn out cloudy. And for the alcohol, you can buy the expensive one. It's like $30 a bottle for this one, or $3 a bottle for the methylated spirits. Methyl is alcohol. It's just got that smell to it, but it all burns off in the process of the cook, so it's the methylated spirits is fine to use. So I'm just going to melt these down in the microwave to speed things up a bit, then I'll come back and do the lye and the water and stuff, and then we'll begin to cook the soap. Make sure you put your glasses on when handling lye, and gloves. Like, if you, a lot of people are really scared to work with lye, but as long as you treat it with respect and wear the safety stuff. If you do happen to splash a little bit on your skin, just get to some water and wash it off thoroughly and you should be fine. When you're mixing it, make sure you're in a well ventilated area and don't breathe in the fumes. But yeah, it's not going to burn a hole in your skin or anything if you do splash a bit on yourself, as long as you wash it off more or less straight away. You know, if you don't do that, you can get a burn from it, but you just got to treat it with respect and you'll be fine. So I'm just going to measure out 180 mil of the demineralized water. Doesn't really matter if it's a bit over. And so now I'm going to pull the lye in and do it nice and slowly. You don't want any big splashes or anything like that. There's always a little bit left in there. Never ever pour your water onto lye. You must always pour the lye onto water. It's like you've got to look at it like snow falling on water, and you'll be right. Now, during this part, just stand back a little bit, because you don't want to breathe in those fumes. Just stir it nice and slowly until it's all dissolved. There's still a tiny little bit in my cup there. Now you can see here that the stearic acid has taken a little bit longer to dissolve. But you just give it a bit of a stir around and it'll dissolve. So now I'm going to pour the lye in. Do that with your glasses and gloves on. nice and slowly, small bits at a time. Just give that a good stir as you're going around. Now don't go splashing this around and doing it really roughly. You've got to, you know, work nice and slowly when you're working with lye, not to splash it. So that's all mixed in now, and now it's time to add the alcohol. So I'm just going to wash out my container and use the same one. So for the alcohol, you'll need 189 mil of the alcohol. You want to have your slow cooker on low. And just add it nice and slowly while you stir that in. If you add it all in together, you might get a great big foam up and lose half your soap mixture on your bench. I add it nice and slowly and it doesn't ever do that. It can get quite fumy as well, so again, work in a well ventilated area. This is where I find my, when doing this, that the soap can go that tan colour. So now it's just a matter of cooking that for about an hour. And today I'm going to cut up some other pieces of soap that I made and put them in the bottom of the mold. So when it's like set, you should be able to see this soap through it. Dissolving that a little bit before I add it in here. I shouldn't really do that because you can just do that all day. Yeah, so this is my sugar water, 113 grams of white sugar mixed with some 75 ml of the demineralized water. I just put it in the microwave to dissolve it. But this is supposed to make it a little bit more clearer, but it doesn't look real clear today. It looks very brown. Put that in there. And some glycerin, that's for like just to make it a nicer soap. So 100 ml of, or about 115 ml of this one. And then give that a stir. And that's it. It's your cooked soap. Clear soap. So now I've just got to get a little cup and pour it into the mold. I can't cut up some soap that I made yesterday. A little cup I need. Oh, I forgot my fragrance. Dee dee dee. Oh, that's a bit brown. Let's give that a stir around. And that was a little bit of grapefruit, patchouli, ylang ylang. What else? Can't think. Orange, sweet orange. Smells nice. It doesn't look real clear. Probably the patchouli did that. Hope you can see. Too much because I've put the soap in, it's taking out some of the volume. Why are they floating to the top? I'm not supposed to do that.